mother introduced me to the practice. She had been doing yoga for many years, my whole life really, but she began Bikram yoga when I was in high school. She made an effort to bring me out to California and meet Bikram, and that was my first yoga class. It resonated for me right away because I was already involved in, you know, physical training, and I just knew it was going to help a lot with those sports, and it did. I left the sports behind and stayed with the yoga practice. Here's my head. Here's my nose. I'm looking this way. I have a little backward bend in my neck, a forward bend in my thoracic spine, and a backward bend in my lumbar spine. Squeeze, reach, and then arms go back first. So, number one, squeeze.
You know, I think that my greatest challenge is not that different than most people. You know, it's a challenging practice. You know, it is designed to push everybody to their limit and kind of give that confrontation with yourself. You know, what am I capable of? What can I do? Do I sit down or do I keep going? And you know, that I think that process is similar to everybody who practices. You know, whether you're athletic or whether you're out of shape or whether you're young or old or, you know, injured or healthy, I think it's the same process. Figure out how to enjoy it. Figure out how to keep it fun and enjoyable. You know, I think that the community in general is dominated by the sort of raw, like aggressive, you know, push, kill yourself, which is valuable.
So we have to do both. We have to do the active part balanced equally with the passive part. Just as much as you have to push and be aggressive about it, you have to surrender.
If you can't balance those two, then you won't last. Maybe you'll do it a couple years. You'll kill yourself and kill yourself and kill yourself for a couple years. 3, 4, 5 is a long time.
What the purpose of the practice is to use the full range of motion that you have today as much as you can. And hold still and breathe. Use the range of motion that you have, stand still, take a couple breaths, do the other side, change, come back tomorrow. That's it.
The practice is meant to be a daily practice, a regular practice, if not daily. It works as a daily practice. It's not a quick fix. It's a lifestyle.
You know, keep that thing, keep it moving, keep it alive, keep it active. Clear out the junk, detoxify. Come back tomorrow. That's it. Who cares about the postures?
What has made it for me worthwhile to keep that discipline as part of my daily life is that I feel amazing. You know, I love the way it makes me feel.
Turn your whole chest. So this goes forward, this comes back. Stretch up, hands to prayer. Once you can balance here, push the knee back with the help of the elbow, turn your head, chin to the shoulder. Now my wrists go from here, slide the left shoulder forward and the right shoulder back until you're looking at yourself in the mirror. You can see both.
For me, it's just, you know, addressing that challenge, being willing to participate is just based on how I feel. I feel good.